Welcome to another Three Steps to Sketch on Function Transformations. So we've looked at a lot of different graphs and how to transform them. In this video, we will look at a pretty advanced transformation. So we are going to transform the cube root of x equation to get this graph, y equals negative 2 times the cube root of 2x plus 1 minus 3. So there's a lot to break down here, but sticking to the method will make this a pretty easy graph to get. And let's do this using our on the graph method. So we'll have a lot of intermediate graphs and we'll really see these transformations in action. All right, here is our equation again and our outline. So we said we are transforming the parent function, the cube root of x. So that's our sideways snake here. Okay, so that's a good thing to keep in mind before we really jump in. Okay, so now we can break down these transformations. Let's start with our horizontal or x affecting transformations. And we know these are seen in the equation with the x. So in this case, underneath this cube root radical. Okay, so since we have multiple, we really want to be careful about the order that we apply these. We need to make sure we do the correct one first. And it's really easy to know which to do first if you just write out a quick helper equation, 2x plus 1 equals 0. So those are your transformations set equal to 0. And solving this little helper equation will help you know what order to do your transformations in. And it'll help you as you describe these transformations. Okay, so looking at the helper, if you were solving that equation for x, you know you'd start by subtracting 1 from both sides. And that's exactly what transformation you'll do first. So if we're subtracting 1 from our x's, we know that's shifting our graph left 1 unit. Okay, or x's minus 1. Okay. So then, of course, our other transformation must be next. But let's look at what we have. So we have 2x equals negative 1. If we were solving this equation, we know we would divide both sides by 2. Okay, and that's exactly what's going to be happening to our x's in this transformation. We'll be dividing by 2. And that actually compresses horizontally. Okay, so our description will say compresses by 2. I'll abbreviate here. Compressed by 2, or x is divided by 2. All right, so we feel confident that the order is correct and our descriptions are correct. This graph will be shifting left 1 first, and then dividing by 2, or horizontally compressing. Okay, so what's left in the in our equation must be a vertical transformation. So we have this negative 2 out front, and this minus 3 in the back. We know vertical transformations affect the y-coordinates, and we should do these in what we can call PEMDAS order, or order of operations order. Okay, so we know the multiplication will come before the subtraction. Okay, so first we will be multiplying our y's times negative 2, which will both stretch our graph vertically by a factor of 2, and the negative will reflect it vertically, so over the x-axis. So that's negative 2 times all your y-coordinates. Okay, and then save the easiest, probably, for last. The minus 3 moves our graph down 3, or takes away 3 from our y's. All right, so once we have all this analysis, we're ready to move to step 2, and we'll see all these transformations as they happen, because we'll use different colors to show the intermediate graphs as we go through step by step. All right, so let's plot our original graph. So we know we have a point at -1, -1, 0, 0, and 1, 1. So we're just gonna do this slightly and make sure you have some different colors. We want probably 4 additional different colors here. All right, so let's switch to blue. And let's start by taking our original green points and moving them each left 1. And we'll just mark their new location with blue X's. All right, easy enough. Now let's switch to red. Okay, and now from each of the blue points, we'll divide the X coordinate by 2, or will half the distance into the y coordinate so that it compresses horizontally. Okay, so we're going to take our first point. Its x coordinate is negative 2, and when we divide that by 2, it ends up here. So we'll mark that with a red x. The y coordinate doesn't change. Our second point, the x coordinate is negative 1 right now, and when we half it, of course, it's negative 1 half. And then our final point's x coordinate is 0, so it stays put. And that takes care of our horizontal compression. So now let's switch to yellow and get started on the vertical transformations. Okay, so we're working from the red graph now. This is where colors are very helpful, especially when you have so many transformations. Okay, we are going to multiply the y coordinates times negative 2. So this will both stretch our graph vertically by a factor of 2, and it will reflect us over the x-axis. Okay, so first point, the y coordinate's negative 1. Multiply it by negative 2 and you get 2. Our x coordinate stays the same. Okay, or you could have thought visually, let me reflect this over the x-axis and then double its distance away from the x-axis. Okay, or you could do it in the other order. You could double the distance away from the x and then reflect. You end up in the same spot. Okay, our second point is actually on the x-axis, so the stretch and the reflection, neither of those impact its location, okay, because its y is 0. All right, and then our third red point, its y coordinate is 1, so when you multiply that by negative 2, you end up at negative 2, okay? Or think stretch, reflect, or reflect, stretch. Okay, that tackles that. And finally, let's switch to black. And we will now apply our final transformation, our vertical shift, moving our graph down 3. And remember, we're working from the yellow. Okay, and that's why I've done those check marks off to the side on the outline, just to kind of remember, okay, which graph are we working from, especially if you maybe went away for a minute and then came back, or if you got a buzz on your phone that distracted you. All right, so from our yellow X's, let's shift those down 3. Okay. Down 3, down 3. All right, so we are finished with our transformations and we can now accomplish step 3 so easily. You just darken your final X's. These are your final points. Remember that this graph, look back up at your original graph, we did reflect it over the x-axis, so that will have a reflected shape, okay? You have this vertically reflected shape of a cube root graph. So this one was pretty challenging. I think if you can tackle this one, you should be able to tackle any transformation of a function using this three steps to sketch method with no problems at all.